Because everybody understands the season we are in as a nation. And we had a very powerful word brought by one of the politicians and leaders in America. And he said something that really touched me. I got that message. It's like I was dabbing in my head. I can paraphrase almost everything.
It's
like in the world today, we have 300 billion trillion of dollars in wealth of the world.
Tuko na utajiri ambao kiwango yake ni matrilioni ya pesa.
Habana matrilioni ya pesa? 300 billion trillion.
Yani million, eh?
300 billion dollars.
Madora.
Hiyo ndio utajiri wa dunia.
Hiyo basi ndio hiyo.
If you ask what is the wealth of the whole world? The wealth of the world is 300
billion
trillion dollars.
Hey.
And he says this.
Na akasema hii.
Despite all that worldly wealth,
licha ya utajiri huo wote wa ulimwengu,
the world is more insecure.
Ulimwengu hauna usalama.
The world is more divided.
Ulimwengu umegawanyika.
There is no love.
Hakuna upendo.
There is hatred.
Kuna chuki.
There is divisions.
Kuna migawanyiko.
Technology has grown very fast.
Teknolojia nayo imekua sana.
But it has made the world to remain more lonely.
Lakini imefanya ulimwengu ubakie upweke.
And there is a lot of loneliness in the world.
Na kuna upweke mwingi katika dunia.
And it only proves one point.
Na inadhibitisha tu jambo moja.
It is not wealth or the technology or the things we can make for ourselves that can make us happy.
Sio utajiri ama mambo ambayo tunaweza tengeza ambayo italete furaha.
It is only God.
Ni Mungu peke
yake. It is following the teachings of Jesus Christ.
Ni kufuatilia mafunzo ya Yesu Kristo.
And here masaist.
Na katilia mkaso.
On the need of loving your neighbor as yourself.
Katika kupenda jirani yako kama vile
unajipenda. Even as God commanded the children of Israel.
Kama vile Mungu aliagiza wana wa Israeli.
Leviticus 19 verse 18.
Katika mambo ya Walawi 18 mstari wa
19:18. Please give me Leviticus if you can. Leviticus chapter 19:18. Leviticus of Leviticus 19:18.
19 mstari wa 18.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Leviticus.
Leo tuna technician wapya kwa mitambo. Haleluya. Kwa hivyo msiogope. Tulieni. Safari ni njema.
1 2 3 Do not seek revenge or bear a grudge against one of your people, but love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord. Read it again. 1 2 3 Do not seek revenge or bear a grudge against one of your people, but love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord. He said, the whole of the Bible is about loving your neighbor.
Akasema Biblia yote ni kuhusu kupenda jirani.
And it was a powerful moment.
Na ikawa ni wakati ulio.
And while that was going on,
wakati haya yalikuwa yanaendelea,
I felt a deep burden.
Nikahisi msigo mkuu.
To rise up as a church.
Kuinuka kama kanisa.
Even as we have been doing.
Hata kama vile tumekuwa tukifanya.
To pray for this country.
Kuombea taifa hili.
I know you know very well.
Najua unafahamu vyema.
That as a church we have been praying every day from Monday through Friday.
Ya kwamba kama kanisa tumekuwa tukiomba kutoka Jumatatu mpaka
Ijumaa. We meet here, most of us who have been able to meet.
Tumekuwa tukikutana wale wameweza.
At times we meet 10, 15, 20 people.
Wakati mwingine 10 watu 20.
And every day we pray.
Na kila siku tunaomba.
We have done prayer for the last 3 years.
Tumeofanya maombi kwa miaka 3.
Every day from Monday through Friday, and then we Saturday there are people who have vacation here, and then Sunday. That means as a church, for almost and over the last 3 years, we have been praying.
Hiyo ni kumaanisha kama kanisa kwa miaka 3 kila siku tumekuwa tukiomba.
And that is why I have a problem.
Na ndio sababu niko na shida.
When I get the so-called ambulance believers, ambulance bishop, they start now mobilizing people, texting. We are going to have a meeting, and Honorable So and So will be there. We shall be praying for the country. I don't want those rubbish. I don't want those nonsense.
That
you. If you have been waiting for Honorable So-and-so to come for the meeting so that you can pray for Kenya, I don't want those kind of things. If you don't know your responsibility is to pray for your family, pray for your children, pray for the church, pray for the country. Don't wait for somebody somewhere